Hello friends, welcome to Electric Junction, a YouTube channel for electrical engineering students. Friends, today I will explain the working and I will also show you the what is an ELCB. Okay, so friends, consider a situation where short circuit occurs in your circuit. Then which device comes into play? Friends, it is MCB which protects the circuit against short circuit current. Are a short circuit condition. When a phase wire comes in contact with a neutral wire, then a heavy short circuit occurs in the circuit, and then the MCB will trip and the devices will be protected against this fault. But friends, what if a person comes in contact with a phase wire? Will the MCB function in this condition as well and it will trip the circuit? No friends, the circuit will not get tripped, and therefore the person who has come into contact with the live wire will get a huge shock, and his life can also end there. So friends, in this condition another circuit comes into play, and which this device is called as ELCB. Okay, so let me first write the name. It is ELCB. Okay, and its full form is earth leakage circuit breaker. Okay, it is earth leakage circuit breaker. So friends, before we open the device and see what is inside a ELCB, first of all we must read the working principle behind it, and we must theoretically understand what is an ELCB. And after understanding theory, I will also show you the practical device and also various parts inside it. So friends, this is called as earth leakage circuit breaker. So as the name suggests, it is a circuit breaker which trips the circuit whenever a leakage occurs in the circuit. Okay, so the leakage might be through various routes. Okay, like the leakage current get route through our body if a human comes in contact with the circuit, and if a live wire comes in contact with the body of a machine, then the body of the machine is also connected to the earth, then there might happen a leakage. In this condition as well, the ELCB comes into play and it trips the circuit, and hence it protects the whole circuit against leakage currents. Okay, so I will draw a simplified diagram to explain the whole working of ELCB. Okay, so friends, for a single phase supply, we have two wires or two terminals. Okay, one is phase wire. Okay, phase conductor. This is phase conductor PH, and the other conductor is neutral conductor. Okay, this is neutral. Yeah. Okay, so friends, inside a MCB, the main component of it is a magnetic core. Okay, so let me draw the magnetic core. Okay, this is the magnetic core of the ELCB. Okay, and this core is generally constructed using a ferrite core. Okay, ferrite core or any magnetic material, but generally we see that it has been constructed using ferrite core. Okay, for the good characteristics of ferrite as a magnetic material. Okay, so for there are we bound two coils around this magnetic core. Okay, first is connected to the phase wire. Okay, this is the phase coil. Okay, this is phase coil, and another coil which is bound around this magnetic material is for neutral coil. for the return conductor. Okay. So friends, the whole circuit is connected. This phase is given to the load circuit. This load, and the neutral of our load is connected to this second coil which was constructed for the neutral conductor. Okay. So friends, this I am showing here only the load. Okay, it might be your domestic circuit, your house wiring, your light and fan wiring, your power socket wirings, etc. But I am simply showing here a box and I have named it as load. Okay. So there are four terminals in a single phase MCB. Okay. First two terminals, which is numbered by odd numbers, one is 1 and 3, these terminals are for supply port. Okay. And the outer two terminals, other two terminals which are written by positive numbers, are the output terminals. Okay. So friends, what happens when the circuit is actuated? Friends, when we connect the supply to the MCB, okay, so here if we consider the load is of 5 ampere, okay, the load is of 5 ampere, so it will draw a current of 5 ampere. This 5 ampere current will flow through the coil first. It will flow through this first coil. I am simply naming it as coil number first. Okay, so when the current flows through this coil, it will generate a magnetic flux. Okay, friends, by our knowledge of electromagnetism, we know that whenever a current flows through a coil, then a magnetic flux get induced in it. Okay, so friends, this coil will generate a magnetic flux which will flow through this ferrite core. Okay, so friends, this current is flowing in this direction. It is going inside the coil and coming out of the coil. Okay, so this is generating a clockwise magnetic flux lines. Okay, so now friends, when this current comes after flowing this load and enters the second coil, the direction changes. Okay, now the direction is towards outward. Okay, so this current will generate opposite flowing flux. Okay, so both these fluxes will cancel each other and the net magnetic flux inside the coil will be zero. Okay, so friends, this is balanced condition when there is no leakage current. But what happens if a main comes in contact with this positive supply? Okay, let me draw the symbol for a human body. Okay, so this is a main who has come into contact with the supply line. So friends, if he comes in contact with this phase line, then some current will flow through his body. Let me consider that now the body is getting 2 ampere current. Now the load is drawing total 5 ampere current. This 5 ampere current will divide into two currents. Here 2 ampere current is flowing to the ground and other 3 ampere current is flowing through the load. Okay, but in this first coil, this whole 5 ampere current is flowing through this coil. So the magnitude of these flux lines will be higher, but here the neutral conductor is getting only 3 ampere current. Okay, because 2 ampere current is flowing through the body. Now the 3 ampere current is flowing in the load, and this 3 ampere current will return after flowing through the neutral coil. Okay, so this neutral coil will generate only flux due to only 3 ampere current. Okay, so as the neutral coil is getting less current, therefore it will also generate a weaker field flux than the first coil. Okay, so there will be a net flux which is in the clockwise direction. Okay, friends, if we wind another coil which is trip coil around this flux, then around this ferrite core, then these flux lines will cut by this coil, and it will get induce a current which will flow through our sensing circuit, which is the trip circuit, and this trip circuit will open the phase lines and the neutral lines. As the current flows through it, this trip coil disconnects the supply lines, and therefore this person who has come into contact with the supply lines will be protected. Okay, so friends, this is the working principle of a basic ELCB, okay, earth leakage circuit breaker. So now friends, let us see an actual ELCB and also try to understand what is inside the ELCB. Okay, so friends, this is a practical and physical ELCB, which is earth leakage circuit breaker. So friends, this device is also termed as RCCB. So friends, RCCB stands for residual current circuit breaker. So both are the same devices. Okay, don't get confused with the terms. Okay, RCCB and ELCB are the both the same things. Okay, so friends, let me first introduce about various terminals. So friends, this is a three phase ELCB. Okay, this ELCB is used for three phase supply. So there are three terminals for the input port. Okay, three terminals for the three phase, and one terminal is for neutral. Okay, so these terminals are used for providing the input to the ELCB. Okay, friends, you will also notice that these terminals are numbered in using odd numbers. Okay, so the odd numbers represent that these terminals are for input supply. Okay, or and the neutral terminal is indicated by symbol N. Okay, by the capital letter N. Okay, likewise friends, there are four terminals in the output port. The three terminals are for three phases and the other one is for neutral. Okay, and the terminals are numbered using even numbers. Okay, friends, there is a new lever to on and off this ELCB. Okay, this position represent the on position. Here I input on is also written, and this position represent the off condition of the ELCB. Okay, friends, you can also regularly check the ELCB using this test knob. Okay, this push button, when you push this push button, the supply should be get tripped. If the supply don't get tripped when you push this button, it represent that your ELCB has gone bad. Okay, so your ELCB is fault. So friends, I suggest you that you must regularly check this test button. Okay, test button. Okay friends, now I come on to the point of rating. As far as its rating is concerned friends, there are ELCB which comes into three range. Okay, 30 milliampere, 20 milliampere and 100 milliampere. Okay, so friends, this milliampere current represents the limiting range of the ELCB. Okay, so this ELCB will protect a leakage current which will be more than 30 milliampere. Okay, so this represents the minimum amount of leakage current which will trip the ELCB. Okay, friends, there you will also know noticing one another rating. It has been written on this side. It is 40 ampere. So friends, this 40 ampere represent how much current on which this device will operate. Okay, so this device will operate only up to 40 ampere. Okay, it can bear only 40 amperes. Okay, this is its limitation. Friends, now here you will also notice various ratings. So friends, the most important rating is the voltage rating. This ELCB can operate up to 450 volts. Okay, this is a three phase ELCB, so it can bear up to 415 volts. Now friends, let us open its front cover and see what is inside this ELCB. So friends, for opening this ELCB, you will have to loosen this four screws. Okay, 1, 2 here 3 and this 4. So friends, let us open this ELCB. Friends, we have opened the screws. Now let us remove the front cover and see what is inside. Okay, so friends, here you will notice that here the copper connections for both input and output terminals, and here you will notice that it is the tripping circuit. Okay, so it will get signal when we will have any kind of leakage, or there will be if any kind of flux induced in the ferrite core, then this relay will have this trip circuit will trip the supply. Okay, so here it is your testing signal. Okay, so friends, now let us open these two screws as well, these two screws, and then we will remove the whole assembly. Okay, the back current, we will have to remove the back current as well for showing inside this circuit. So let us remove the back cover as well. So friends, I have finally removed both the front cover as well as the back cover, and now you will notice that these were the input terminals, output terminals, and these were the input terminals. Okay, so friends, here you will notice that this is the ferrite core magnet, okay, magnetic material, and you will also notice that these three phase wires are being used for constructing three coils. Okay, and this is the this is trip coil. Okay, so friends, whenever there is an unbalanced flux rotates inside this ferrite core, a flux, this unbalanced flux will be cut by this coil wire, trip coil wire, and this will send a message, a tripping signal to this tripping circuit, and this trip circuit will trip the whole supply. Okay, in this way this ELCB protects the human body against earth leakage circuit faults. Okay, so friends, this circuit is very useful where a leakage current exceeds the permissible limits. Okay, so friends, here you can also see the mechanism of the push button. Okay, when friends we push this push button, then this soldering on the PSB on the PCB gets shorted, and it shorts the resistance. Okay, here you will you must be noticing a power resistor. Okay, it is a power resistor for dissipating the huge amount of heat which will get generated when we short circuit this circuit. Okay, so friends, in this way we can also check the ELCB regularly. So friends, it was all which ELCB consists. So friends, I hope you must have liked this video, and friends, if you have any doubts, you must comment in our comment section. Friends, you can also share this video, and friends, if you have not subscribed my channel, so friends, don't forget to subscribe my channel, and you can also log on to our website sandeepagarmortutorial.com. friends, you can also watch this video in Hindi language in my channel Sandeep Agarmore Tutorial.